You're watching Let's Chat.
Mark your calendar Thursday, September 2nd. Why? It's the kickoff of the UTC football season. Once again, head coach Rusty Wright is joining us this morning to kind of give us a preview of what's going on. Coach Wright, first of all, good morning. I know your plate is overflowing this time of year. Tell me what the first thing you thought of this morning as it pertains to football was when you woke up.
Trying to figure out the weather for the next couple of days. That was the biggest thing, trying to figure out how we can practice and do all that.
Leave that to me. You were quoted last week as saying one of the biggest assets that you have got this year around. Pretty good depth chart all the way around. Tell me your feelings on that.
Well, COVID gave us an extra year, you know, and we had some young men that decided to hang around and not go ahead and graduate and exhaust their eligibility. So that's given us an opportunity to kind of bring some young guys along and keep some older guys around to give us a chance to have an older group, per se, than you normally would have, because a lot of folks in this transition have lost people,
sure.
You know, guys that went on with life and done those things. So we're excited about having that group around.
And you have all 22 starters from last year coming back, correct?
Yeah, right now.
That's got to be a heck of an advantage, though, right?
Well, it is. It's exciting. It is. It's exciting because it's a group that understands what we're trying to do and how we're trying to do things. So I'm excited for that fact. Excited for those kids to have an opportunity to truly go through a real football season again.
What are your observations so far up until this very minute?
We're getting better. I mean, we are. We're getting better. We got an opportunity to be a good football team. How good we can be is going, you know, how we put it together on Thursday night and the Saturday nights to follow. So I'm excited about that fact. I'm excited to see how good of a football team we can be.
On the quarterback front, let's begin with offense. You got, what, four or five guys who could be starters. That's got to be comforting to you and the offensive line staff. Yeah, you haven't named a starter yet. Any particular reason?
We're just trying to find the guy that best fits us, you know, best fits what we can do, and a guy that's going to give us the best opportunity to win and take control of things. And, you know, right now we got about three guys, really, that are battling for that spot, and that somebody's got to step up and just go be the guy. You know, but I feel good about all three of them, honestly, I do, but putting them in the game and letting them play.
What will be the aha moment when the light bulb goes off above your head and you go, that's my guy, that is our starter?
Yeah, still waiting for that to happen, you know. It may be playing in the first game, it may be playing in the second or third game, I don't know. We just got to try and figure that out, and it's going to be the guy that controls that offense and doesn't turn the ball over, makes good decisions, and gives us an opportunity.
And I believe today is the first full day of classes at UTC, so the players get kind of a break to sort of concentrate on their academic lives, but yet they're hitting it still pretty hard and pretty heavy when it comes to practice. What's been your favorite takeaway from the practices you've had so far?
Just the amount of people we have involved now. So than my first couple of years here, the number of bodies and the number of quality people we have there, that's been the biggest thing is, my first year here, we didn't have quite enough folks, you know, practicing and doing those things. And we ended practice yesterday with 102 guys practicing. So, I mean, I think that's the biggest thing is we've got better people and more of them, and that'll help us.
The academic aspect of your team, they're, what, a 3.0 GPA average? And this has all been since you came into the picture. What kind of motivational speech? We'll leave it like that. Did you give the guys to make sure that they had their act together in the classroom as well as on the field?
Well, the biggest thing is football stops for all of us at some point in time, playing the game anyway. And we talked about the number one thing you come to school for is to get a degree. That's the only thing they're ever going to leave with. They're not going to leave with a helmet or a football or anything like that. Hopefully they get a ring along the way, but they're going to leave with that college degree. And that's the biggest thing we've harped on them since we've been here, is just making sure they understand that's the one piece you're going to take with you for the rest of your life, and nobody will ever take that away from you. Once you get that college degree, you get it, and it's yours, and it'll open up a lot of doors for you.
And this has got to be kind of a special chapter in your life since you are now the head coach at your alma mater. How does that inspire you to proverbially and maybe occasionally literally kick the players in the butt?
Well, my feet hit the floor every morning, and we're trying to make this place as good as we can for these young people and try to give them the best experience we can for it. And I don't take that lightly. I mean, because I've been through it. I've walked those same hallways, slept in those same dorms, done all those things. So it's important for me, for those young men, to have a good experience here, to give everything I have to them, to give them an opportunity to go and experience college and football the best way they can.
What do you think the big the big thing that the fans are going to take away after the first game?
Hopefully you see a football team that's hungry, that's ready to play again, that's excited about playing this fall. I think you'll see a group that wants to do well, wants to be a good football team, will push themselves to do that. And, you know, I think you'll see a large group of guys pulling for each other that'll give us an opportunity as this season keeps going.
All right, first game. Got a prediction. I know coaches hate when I ask them this, but I got to ask you. First game coming up September the 2nd. How you feeling?
We're going to play well. We'll play well. We're playing a really good football team. Mm-hmm. We are. We're playing a really good football team. Austin Peay actually probably has more all-conference, more all-American guys than we do. They have a lot of folks like that. But I know our young people will be excited and looking forward to it and put the work in and go give ourselves an opportunity.
But you as a coach, and I know this from talking to some of your former players and your colleagues, you thrive on a challenge like that.
Well, I mean, what else are we doing it
you
for?
You don't just rise to it. You thrive on it, and you go a little bit above and beyond it. Hope you'll come back and join us over the coming weeks. Plenty of season tickets are still available. Get them right now at GoMocs.com. That is GoMocs.com. And again, it's Austin Peay coming up at September the 2nd. We'll see you back here tomorrow at 10.